biri bum 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 biri bum 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 biri bum 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 biri bum 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 biri bum bum bum. This week's green tip is all about a topic that is very important to me. It's all about water conservation. Water conservation is really important to me because if you look at things, the way human population is, it's growing and growing and growing. But if you look at our water supply, it's right now kind of staying the same. And cities are already rationing water, when you can water, when you can't water your yard and things like that. And so to me, it just makes economical sense and just overall good sense to start conserving as much rainwater as you can. With me today, I have the Rain Ranchers. It's a very special father-daughter company that's all about rainwater harvesting. They've done these really large retail rainwater harvesting, and they've also done residential, so they kind of know the whole scope of things. So with me today, without any further ado, is Jen Davis of the Rain Ranchers. Jen?
Hi, I'm Jen Davis. You might remember me from such green tip films as Raise Your Own Chickens. Today, I'm going to talk about the Rain Ranchers.
I want to ask you a bunch of questions. I want to have them answered immediately.
What would the size be for a residence? Like 30 gallons, 40 gallons?
Standing behind me actually is an install that we did for a residence. This beautiful beauty right here is 500 gallons.
Okay, so 500 gallons for a residence, that's pretty good.
We design, install, and maintain all systems as small as 55 gallons, 500 gallons, and 20,000 gallons. We actually installed 5 20,000 gallon tanks at a Tanger Outlet Mall in Texas City last summer.
Oh, so you don't just do residential, you also do retail?
That is correct.
So let me ask you, Jen, if I'm collecting water, aren't I increasing the chances of breeding mosquitoes?
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Good thing about these tanks, not only are they rainwater tanks, but they also come rainwater ready. They come with the mosquito screen, which also serves as our manhole. The mosquito screening is very tightly woven, so no critters, no bugs, especially no mosquitoes, can get into your rainwater and contaminate it.
All right, so you thought of mosquitoes. What about sticks? I get some sticks that fall on my roof. What's gonna happen to those? Are they gonna clog up the system?
We use a leaf eater. It's as simple as it sounds. It deflects all the leaves and all the twigs out of your piping and out of your tanks.
You've thought of sticks. Wow, y'all are good. Okay, what about dirt and pollen and all that kind of stuff? It's a little smaller and it's really dirty. I mean, that water, the first water that comes off the rain is so dirty. I don't really want to collect that.
This tube right here, it is called the first flush diverter. And a first flush diverter aids in the pre-filtration of the rainwater before the water goes into your tank. You want to keep the water as clean as possible going into your tank, so it's as clean as possible coming out of the tank. So, my first flush diverter catches all the first rain that falls off of your roof, because you know, as your roof is not the cleanest spot to be. So, all the dirtiest water fills in this tube first, catches dirty, dirty, dirty. As it starts to fill up, the water gets cleaner. So then it kicks over and into the tank. This is a dry conveyance first flush diverter. This first flush diverter is maintenance free. It has a slow release nipple at the bottom, and it's also got a filter screen inside so no little debris can get in here. And this couple actually decided to use this water. As I said before, it's not bad water, it's just the dirtiest water. But it can still be used. So this couple hooked a poly line up to the slow release nipple and has it running out into their flower beds. Like I said, it's maintenance free, so it will drain itself out and be ready for the next rain.
Okay, Jen, I've thought of another question. What happens when the tank overflows? It's big and heavy and it's on the corner of your foundation. And with all that water there, it's gonna sink in, and I don't wanna have foundation issues.
The overflow is very important because you want any water that fills up and out of your tank to be diverted away from any foundation, your foundation of your tank or your foundation of your house. This This couple actually chose to use their overflow water so they have it pointed directly to a flower bed, which is absolutely fine and ideal. No water wasted is good water not wasted.
Wow, it sounds like this was very specifically designed for a home or garden.
And why that is so, you can look down here. It has two spigots. One to put a bucket underneath and one to collect any or connect any hose to. So that is why they are especially good for rainwater, the two spigot options.
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
My father Ken started this business several years ago and I recently joined teams with him and have been collecting water ever since.
And my name is Ken.
And I'm Jen.
And we are the Rain Ranchers.
Well, Jen and Ken, the only thing you're missing is a theme song.
Catch free water, catch free water, catch free water from Rain Ranchers.
So be sure to start collecting rainwater today and call my friends the Rain Ranchers. I'm Jason Winningham.
And I'm Jen Davis.
And this has been your Green Tip of the Week.
Who are you?
Who are you?
I'm Detective John Kimball.
Hey, this is the motel.